every day we'd come in and say, how are we going to get all this stuff done when we need to have it done by? I was starting to work a lot of hours. Scott Evans was looking for something to do.
I got a phone call. I was driving, so I pulled over and Dan proceeded to say that
we were going to do something very interesting. Would I like to be a part of it?
There wasn't even thought. It was
absolutely.
They did provide complementary skills, with Scott's background being mostly with general aviation and Scott Martin's being in the military.
He lived inside the brain of all of our customer pilots.
One would pull one way and one would pull another, and they had to come to a resolution. I think that worked to our advantage.
Iron sharpens iron.
I'm a big believer things happen the way they're supposed to. And Scott and I were just meant to work on this program together. We just meshed.
And it ended up being the perfect guy to add to the team at the perfect time. When Scott first saw what we were doing, he's like, you guys are an ambitious bunch, aren't you? How'd you get this past Press and Dan?
What surprised me the most, how willing we were to press the edge of what had been done before. One of the hardest things about starting from scratch is, what do you want this airplane to be? Because you've got an
opportunity. It can be exciting, but it's also very daunting.
Oh, it's very exciting. The engineering characteristics, how the two pilots were going to interact with each other.
I was more interested in, what is the pilot going to see and physically interact with? I would go home at night, sit down at the kitchen table with my daughter's crayons and start drawing these pictures. Bring them in the next day, sit down in Scott's office with Susan and Aaron.
I didn't see the crayon drawings.
Hey, what do you think about this?
Scott would come up with ideas on no paper.
He's a character.
For an artist, I would give him sixth grade level. But he was very good at getting his point across.
His favorite story is going to probably be the sidestick and how he started that off with a lump of clay
and squish in my hand. And that started putting little balls of clay on top of it for, oh, I got to have a knob here and I got to have a knob here.
Hey, what do you think about this?
The clay glob was the first one I saw.
Scott Evans looks at that thing and said, what is all that junk on the top of that thing? We need a push to talk button and an autopilot button, and that's it. So I asked Michael Knight, hey, can you 3D scan this somehow?
He was bringing it around to other pilots and saying, hey, you know, what do you think about this shape?
Yeah, but what about a little bit more here or there?
We had at least 30 pilots have their hands on it and try it.
I took it home and I'm sitting on the back porch with some more modeling clay and my Dremel tool. You can tell when you're starting to get close, when everybody, it's not too bad, but.
He'd work on the shape some more, and then over time it became the shape that we have today.
But as you can see, what we have on the final product made it into a real sort of piece of jewelry, if you like.
When I think back to the days of sitting on the back porch being covered in dust and clay and seeing this finished product and thinking that was 2 years and at least 20 people and I would say 100 iterations. To see that in there, every time the whole thing flashes before my eyes.